I mean, I don't think I'd use the word alarm. This is a cyber breach. I don't think it's going to cause lives. It's not going to draw blood. It doesn't have the ferocity of acts of terror, kind of. But at the same time frame, we have to do something about it. We're responding to way more breaches than the SolarWinds breach. You know, you've read about maybe in the last week, four different zero-day attacks against Microsoft Exchange. It appears like that threat actor went a little bit broader than the SolarWinds attack. So long story made short, we have about 550 folks on the ground responding to breaches right now, and I'm not sure the climate's ever been worse for the amount of work that we have. You don't want to spray and pray with a zero day. The reason that was done is most likely the threat actors recognized the zero day was coming up to end of life. So they just hit everything they could with it and put a backdoor in place. You know, they put this secret door in every single house in the neighborhood kind of thing. And that's what they did here. The backdoor that they put in place is exceptionally consistent with the Chinese threat actors. We don't have rules of engagement in cyberspace. Modern nations don't have rules they're playing by. And what I just saw was China doing something they don't normally do. So that means they're expanding, they're incrementing what they are thinking is permissible. So we're gonna have to define rules. In cyber, if you really assess the domain, the United States is actually not really winning right now, in my opinion. If we hack back, it's like being in the glass house throwing rocks at a mud hut. I mean, honestly, the amount of attacks is as fast as packets can travel these days. Cyber is probably the wrong domain right now to exert force. It may be a domain to do some force, but I would think about diplomacy, alliances, economics, and applying some pressure in those things. Because if we get in a cage match in cyber, the United States is going to lose more than it probably gains against the adversary.
The Trump administration failed to prioritize cybersecurity.
You know, governments were formed to protect their citizens. If we don't know who we're protecting from, we can't impose risk or consequence to those folks. So we've got to know who did it. And that's going to take international cooperation. It's going to take supporting intelligence assets. It's going to have technical assets, human assets, whatever we need to do. But our allies can help. And I can tell you, everywhere in the world, the toleration for ransomware is coming down very quickly. People are getting tired of it.